He may have gotten away with murder. Clues in an unsolved case point to one man.
As our week on unsolved murders continues, our Vanessa Murphy shows you why.
Deputy Mark Reid remembers making the gruesome discovery.
A couple times that day, I could smell a strong smell when I drove through here.
That led to an unforgettable moment.
I was pretty spooked at the time. I've never walked up on something like that at that point in my career.
Reid found a young woman's body, later identified as Becky Robinson. She was a mother of four who had trouble with drugs and prostitution.
The whole thing was pretty sad to me, you know, just that someone would actually back someone in and dump them like that.
According to court records, Becky's body may have been here for a week. Macon County Sheriff Tom Schneider says it's not known exactly how she died. She was never reported missing, but he believes foul play was involved. And the last person to be seen with her, an estranged boyfriend.
The boyfriend is an individual that we consider to be uncooperative.
He's Alto Sizemore. He was arrested after the murder and his home and vehicles were searched, but Sizemore has never been formally charged.
I am telling you that we do have a person of interest on this case.
Schneider won't confirm whether that's Sizemore, but the court records reveal so much. Becky Robinson had a restraining order against him at one point. He was convicted of domestic battery for hurting her, and according to court records, witnesses told police Becky was seen hiding from him. She was afraid he was going to kill her, and he was seen threatening to kill her. And one witness told police on the last day she was seen alive, he saw Becky with her head laid back in Sizemore's car, but Sizemore said she was passed out.
We've had uncooperative individual or individuals involved in this case that cause us to basically run into a roadblock when it comes to investigating it.
But Schneider still remains hopeful the killer will be caught.
I take satisfaction in the fact that we're able to let that person know we never forgot about this person that's dead. We are actively working this case, and we're going to be coming after you if at all possible whenever we get enough information.
Somewhere, someone knows something about it, and I hope they will one day call in.
It's a chapter Reid hopes to close.
You still, it bothers you as you ride by.
Just one simple tip could help put one man behind bars.
Now, I tried reaching Alto Sizemore, but instead talked with his son. He says his father lives in Peoria and would call if he wanted to talk with me. He never did. If you have any information about this unsolved case, call the Macon County Sheriff's Office. You can also remain anonymous by calling Crime Stoppers.